Hi, it's me, Jeff. We go to museums to look at art, but have you ever looked at the frames around a work of art? We're going to find out more about that today and even make a frame of our own. Welcome to Sketch with Jeff.
One, two.
It's Mr. Jeff. It's Mr. Jeff. And his show.
And pencil, too. It's Sketch with Jeff.
Oh, hi. Welcome to Sketch with Jeff. As always, I'm really excited to see you. I usually talk about artwork on Sketch with Jeff, but today we're thinking about frames. Yes, the kind of frames that you would put around a work of art. Frames are interesting because they come in many different styles. A frame could be fancy, or it could be plain, or it could be colorful, or it could be really shiny. I think my helper, Pencil, is thinking about frames. Let's check in with her. Pencil? Pencil, where are you?
Hi, Jeff.
Oh, there you are. What are you doing?
I made a self-portrait. I'm trying to put a frame on it. But there's so many frames to choose. How do I decide?
I guess you start by looking at the artwork.
Wait a second, Jeff. My self-portrait was here. Where did it go? Ah, it's probably in with these frames.
Oh, shh, don't tell Pencil, but I have a big surprise for her. I'm actually the one that took her self-portrait. I took it and brought it to a friend at the Guggenheim Museum. This friend is named Peter, and he's an expert in frames. I'm hoping that he might make a special frame for Pencil's self-portrait. I met with him. I had a really fun conversation. So let's go check out that conversation at the Guggenheim Museum. I met Peter inside the galleries of the Guggenheim Museum. And as we were walking, he mentioned that he has made more than 1,000 frames for artwork inside the Guggenheim Museum. He offered to show me a very special one, which was on view in the exhibition right there. So this is it. I'm looking at this frame and it looks so old. And you're saying you made this?
I did. It's based on a really old style, a Baroque style, which Picasso did collect in the 20s. And so we tried to align with his vision on that. It's also made exactly as it would have been made in the 17th century in Spain. It's hand carved. You'll see a lot of handwork on the frame.
And you did this carving?
I did all of this carving.
That's amazing.
And one thing that's nice about a carved frame, a handmade frame like this, is that no line is actually straight. You can see the working marks, and they really harmonize with the working marks in the painting. You can't look at a painting in any gallery without at least sensing the frame choice around it. Even if you don't focus on it, it's there and it has an impact on the way that we see the painting inside of it.
Do you make other things besides frames?
Oh, I make all sorts of things. I am an artist. I have my own art practice. And I make guitars in my spare time. Many people here at the Guggenheim came to the Guggenheim through their art practice. So there's lots of different artists here with all kinds of really exciting skill sets. I know that Pencil made a really special work of art that she is very, very proud of. And so I took a little bit of time and I made a very special frame for her.
Wow. Look at this, it's Pencil's painting in this beautiful frame. And you made this frame?
I did, I made that frame. It's based on a much older design from the 1400s from Italy. But the great thing about old designs is that they tend to look great on lots of different kinds of works.
Thank you so much, Peter.
Thank you.
I can't thank you enough. That was such a great conversation. I'm really excited. I have an idea for an art project that involves frames. Let's go back to my studio. And I'll show you what I mean. Come on, come on. I made this fun picture of a sun as a gift for a friend, but my frame is very plain, so I want to make a very special frame. I have this matte board, this nice thick board that will fit around the frame, and I'm cutting a really interesting shape. It's got curves, it's got points, and then I'm gluing it to the plain frame. Now I need to really decorate and design this frame so it stands out and looks really fun too. I'm cutting out different shapes of colored paper, but before I use them, I'm going to paint this frame some really bright colors, colors that might go with the theme of my sun picture. I've got bright oranges, bright yellow. And now I'm cutting out some cardboard shapes to glue onto the frame. I want some shapes to pop out, so this thick cardboard will be really nice. I can paint over that cardboard and then glue on my original shapes. I've got triangles, I've got spirals. And now, when I put my son picture inside the frame, wow, that makes it really special. The colors go with the sun inside, and it feels very, very fun. The shapes pop out of the frame, and I love the way everything comes together. You should try this. You can create your own custom frame for your own art. All right, I'm back in the studio. I gave the self-portrait with the frame to Pencil. Let's see what she thinks. Pencil?
Thank you, Peter. I love this frame. I don't even know how to thank you. But since you like guitars, maybe I'll sing a song. Thank you, Peter, for the frame. I love my brand new gold frame. Thank you, Peter. Thank you, Peter, for my frame. Bye.
I'm so glad that Pencil loves her frame. It's really special, and pretty soon she'll be ready for her own art exhibition. In the meantime, I'm going back to thinking about frames, and yeah, I guess I am feeling a little fancy today. I'll see you soon. Bye.
One, two.
It's Mr. Jeff. It's Mr. Jeff. It's Mr. Jeff. It's Mr. Jeff and his show.
And Pencil, too. It's Sketch with Jeff.